To become a parachain on either Kusama or Polkadot, a project has to win a slot auction. At the time of recording this tutorial, the maximum duration a parachain can lease on Kusama is 48 weeks, and on Polkadot, it is 2 years. A full parachain slot can be divided into 8 lease periods. So the minimum duration a parachain can lease on Kusama is 6 weeks, and on Polkadot, it is 3 months. It is interesting to see that so far in Kusama parachain auctions, all the winning teams have bid for the maximum slot duration. Things might play out a little differently in the future. How? Let's look at the mechanics of slot auctions in depth. Let me demonstrate a hypothetical situation where Project A placed a bid for 75 tokens for the entire slot duration, and Project B, which only plans to use 4 lease periods of the slot, bids 100 tokens for the range 1 to 4. Project C observes this bid on chain and bids 60 tokens for the range 5 to 8. Why would they do that? Probably they are still working on their project and are hopeful they can launch it during the 5th lease period of this particular slot. Now, who wins the slot? Let's do the calculation. 75 tokens bonded for 8 lease periods would be 600. 100 tokens locked for 4 lease periods is 400, plus 60 tokens locked for 4 lease periods is 240, which is in total equal to 640. And the winners of the slot auction are projects B and C. Do not be surprised if you see a parachain team that already acquired a slot for the maximum duration participates in an auction halfway through. Now, why would they do that? This parachain team may want to ensure continuity of their service and may not want to take any chances by waiting till the last lease period. They can choose to jump in halfway through and bid for just the last 4 lease periods, there you go, of the newly opened slot auction. If this team is way too conservative, they might even participate in the next lease period right after winning a full slot auction and bid for that one last lease period. And then keep doing this each time a new slot auction opens. This slot auction system ensures that the teams with access to a lot of capital do not hoard entire slot durations. Instead, they would only bid for the lease period they are interested in. This lets the other teams bid for the remaining lease periods whenever a slot auction goes up. This slot auction system also ensures each project gets multiple chances to bid for their continuity of their parachain lease. We shall witness a very dynamic interplay between the parachain teams during the auctions in the near future. Now let's discuss about the mechanics of the auction itself. Kusama and Polkadot use a slightly modified procedure of candle auctions, tailored for an open blockchain implementation. Once the auction starts, project teams will start placing their bids. At a known block number, the candle auction phase starts. It continues for a fixed duration and also ends at a known block number. Within this duration, the projects may keep updating their bids. And here is the interesting part. The auction winning block is randomly picked from the candle auction phase, and whichever team has the highest bid during that block number is declared as the winner of the auction. This simulates the real-world situation where the candle flame is extinguished at some point during the auction, and the winning bid at that point of time wins the auction. Cool. It is worth knowing that both Kusama and Polkadot offer the facility of crowd loans on chain, where the projects can raise the capital for bidding in the auctions. The tokens are lent to the project teams on chain, and if the project wins the slot auction, these tokens are bonded throughout the lease period and then returned back automatically after the lease ends. If the project fails to win the auction, the tokens are returned back to the contributors at the end of the crowd loan campaign. For more information regarding parachain auctions and crowd loans, check out the wiki links posted in the video description. See you.